Well, I had a meeting yesterday with the developer and spoke to someone I help in the council. So it looks like they're accepting the fact that the public won't tolerate houses of any kind, whether it be social or private. And I floated my idea, and the idea that a lot of people have been floating about is very similar with the mansion what it should be used for. Wedding venue, cafe, community project, community hub.
Yeah.
And the land in question that was up for discussion on the houses, that should be turned into an open space with leisure facilities like you'd see in any other park, fit for outdoor events, concerts, stuff like that, just general well-being of the public. And the developer agreed with me on that. So it's just looking at another alternative of how that can be financed. And he did seem very genuine about the park. So when he was quoted in the press as saying he'd walk away if the plans were rejected, and he totally dismissed that idea and said it was, you know, blown up out of all proportion. I wasn't at the meeting, but I kind of took his word for it. And he did seem pretty genuine. Not all about, like I first thought, just taking the land and stuff, so it was a really positive meeting actually, and we've agreed that we'll both work together and speak to the council at looking at a real viable alternative to save the mansion and to upgrade the park, which is really good. So fingers crossed that will be the way it goes, and the sooner the better. The council and mayor release an official statement putting it to bed once and for all. The idea of any kind of social or private houses on the park will be a great day for Salford and a great day for all the people of Salford.